In this video, we're going to look at how to insert various kinds of links into the content of a page in SilverStripe 3. The first kind of link that I want to explore is a link to a file so that people can download it. So I'll go ahead and select some text here that I want to make into a hot link. Actually, I'll just take this much of it. And I will click the Insert Link button. The kind of link that I want to create right now is a file, so I'll click Download File, and I will choose a file from among the files that have been uploaded over here in this area of the CMS. So I have a PDF here in the PDFs folder. I'll click on that, and then I'm going to select to open it in a new window. Anytime that you are making a link to a file for people to download, it's a good idea to have it link into a new window so that when they're done with looking at the file, if it's a PDF or the JPEG or whatever it is, they could just close the window and they're back where they were when they first clicked the link. So I'm going to click Insert Link, and there's my link. And then I'm going to link to another website. So I'll take a couple of words here, I'll insert link, and I'll choose another website. Put the link in there, also opening this in a new window. Anytime that you are going to link elsewhere, you want to open in a new window so that when they are done reading that other website, they can close that window or tab and be back in your website. So we'll go ahead and save and publish those changes and have a look at them in preview mode. So here's our link to our PDF, and this is our link to our other website. Go ahead and click this. You can see it opens a new window. And here is our PDF coming up. And as soon as we're done with this, we can just close it, and we're back where we were. Now, of course, that wasn't a real URL, so if I click it, it's going to give me an error of some kind. So we'll just go back to edit mode. If I put my cursor into a link that exists already, I can either remove it or I can click here to edit it. I could choose to link to an email address and I could paste that in there. I could link to another page within this website, and so I find the pages of the website in this drop down, so I could select that. If there was an anchor on this page that I wanted to link to, it would appear in this drop-down, and I could link to that. If I'm linking to a page within my own website, I want to make sure this is not checked. We don't want to open a bunch of windows of pages in the same website because that's annoying to the user. So we'll uncheck that box, and we'll click Insert Link. And now this link will take us over to the video page if we click on it. And here we are on the video page.